Yes, class here. Today we will start our new unit, unit number 3, and we will start our lesson number 1 of that unit, that is astrology, and the name of the unit is Shirk. This all the lessons of this unit will relate to the Shirk and the oneness of Allah Almighty. This today's lesson is about astrology, and as we know that astrology is the knowledge that relating to stars, and many of us are involved such type of knowledge. We like it very much to ask somebody about our fate, about our future, and we want to show our hands to such persons, such astrologers. So in this lesson will tell us that is such type of knowledge is beneficent to get, or we should get such type of the knowledge, or we should avoid. We will see here in this lesson. So let's start, and there is also the difference between the term astronomy and astrology. So first we will see what is astronomy. Astronomy is the science that deals with the studying the movement of the celestial bodies and reducing observation to the mathematical order. It means that when we get the knowledge relating to the movement of the stars and the subsequent the outcomes or the results are given in the mathematical orders, this type of knowledge is called astronomy. According to the jurists, the study of astronomy, it's called in Arabic ilmul ahya, is lawful. It means that we can get such type of knowledge as it is useful in predicting the beginning of the months, seasons, determining the direction of salah and navigation. So such type of the knowledge that is relating to the movement of star, that is useful for the human being, such type of knowledge we can get. But what is the astrology? On the other hand, it concerned with the studying the position and accept aspects of the celestial bodies in the belief that they have an influence on the course of the natural earthly occurrences and human affairs. So what is astrology? It is actually to get the knowledge of the stars. We study the position of stars and the movements of stars, and believing that their position and their movement had a great effect on everything that happened on the earth. Suppose we say that because of the movement of the stars, the rain will fall, or because of the movement of the stars or position of the star, this will happen to me, and how can I avoid such fate, such all things relating to the astrology. And astrologists believe that the movement of stars has an influence on the people's life. So both Muslims and astronomers and religious scholars refuse the prophecies of astrologists and consider it haram, unlawful. So this type of knowledge, this type of education, if we want to get such type of knowledge, this is unlawful. We are forbidden to get such type of knowledge, as knowledge of the unseen is known only by Allah, because such type of knowledge relates the things towards the future, that what will happen to a person or what will happen on the earth. This is the knowledge of unseen, and it's actually not a practice of the Muslims, because all the Muslims know that the source of knowledge is only Allah Almighty. Except Allah, no one knows that what will happen in the near future or after future, and even we don't know what will happen to us tomorrow or after 1 hour. So no person is Aleem, only Allah Almighty is Aleem. So if a person say that he knows the future, or he will he has any type of proclamation that he will tell you about your future, so it's mean that he is telling lies, or he is trying to be a partner in any attributes of Allah Almighty, nauzubillah. So the scholars agree that astrology is a prohibited field of study. We should not study this type of education. We should not get this type of education. Both fields are rooted in Greek. Astronomy and astrology both have their deep roots in Greek, Persian and Indian tradition, influenced by non-Islamic culture. These cultures actually are non-Islamic, so they have the belief in such things. Astrology was introduced into the royal court by the later Umayyad caliphs and the early Abbasid. Each caliph used to have a court astrologer who would advise him on his day to day affairs and warn him of impending danger. So in the early Muslim caliphs, first Khilafat Rashida and then later on the early Muslim caliphs, they did not do such type of the practices, but later on when their iman was not such strong, that of the Sahaba and later on the other Muslims, so they started such type of the practices and they become the custom to keep an astrologer in the court who will tell them, who would tell them that what would happen to them tomorrow, and if they do such things, what will be the result, and they tell them about the future dangers and future news, and that was totally forbidden. That is totally forbidden. And because the astrology is in its original form was known by the Muslim masses to be kufr, and such type of activities are known to be kufr. Those Muslims who wish to practice and make it appear acceptable, Islamic attributed their predictions to Allah's will. See, it means that the people who claim that they know about the future, they can tell about the future, so it means that they are trying to become the partner in the attributes of Allah Almighty. Nauzubillah. According to the fuqaha, the study of astronomy is halal. As I told you before that, it's about the stars. It's useful in many ways, as it is useful in prediction of the beginning of the month and seasons, in order to know the time of irrigation, determining the direction of the travelers in the desert and the sea. Allah says in Quran, وَهُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ النُّجُومَ لِتَهْتَدُوا بِهَا فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ قَدْ فَصَّلْنَا لِقَوْمِ الْآيَاتِ يَعْلَمُونَ. What's that meaning? It is He who has placed for you the stars that you may be guided by them through the darkness of the land and sea. We have detailed the signs for a people who knows. So we know that the stars, nowadays we have compass and we have the clocks to get the time, and we have compass to find out the directions. But in the previous days, when there were no such facilities, the people used the direction of the stars to find out their directions, even during their traveling, their journey through the seas. They use stars to find out their directions and even to find out the time. So to get the knowledge of stars for their these useful activities, it is halal, and we can get this type of knowledge. It is useful for the human being. In another place, Allah Almighty said that وَلَقَدْ زَيَّنَ السَّمَاءَ الدُّنْيَا بِمَصَابِيحَ وَجَعَلْنَاهَا رُجُومًا لِلشَّيَاطِينِ. What's that meaning? We have beautified the nearest heaven with lamps and made parts of them to be thrown as the devils. So what are the purpose of stars? It beautifies the sky, and it's also used to send the Saturns away from the sky. As the stars are thrown to the Saturns, who reach there to the skies to get some type of information. So as far as astrology is concerned, it is haram, forbidden, because the knowledge of the unseen belong to only Allah. Astrologists allege, it means they say, they proclaim that celestial planets independently influence the course of the natural occurrences with or without intervention of Allah Almighty. So what they proclaim, that they say that something can happen on the earth, something can affect the life of human being even without the interference of Allah Almighty. Nauzubillah. Is it possible that without the order of Allah something can happen? No, nothing can be happened if Allah does not will. Nothing, no one can harm us, no thing can give us any type of harm until there is a will of Allah Almighty. So this kind of the belief is shirk and kufr, because it contradicts the principle of Tawheed. And what is Tawheed? We know very clearly that Allah Almighty alone is powerful. He is Alim, He is Khabir, He can do each and everything, He has all the parts, He can manage the whole universe, He is the creator. So such beliefs, attributes to planets, stars and galaxies, some of Allah's unique attributes. So we cannot give such type of attributes to words, such stars and planets. They cannot do anything until there is a order of Allah Almighty. All Muslim ulama agree that astrology is prohibited field. Ibn Taymiyyah said, astrology that is concerned with studying the position and aspect of the celestial bodies in the belief that they have an influence on the course of the natural earthly occurrences and human affair is prohibited in Quran, the Sunnah, and by the consequences of Muslim scholars. Furthermore, astrology was forbidden by all the messengers of Allah, the Exalted. So, no prophet, there are how many prophets? We all know that there are more than 1 lakh prophets. No prophet encouraged that knowledge, that type of knowledge. And if we also try to get such type of knowledge that believing that stars have influence on the occurrences of the earthly affairs, they have influence on the life of people, they can do anything and they can save somebody from something. So such type of the beliefs and such type of the knowledge is forbidden according to all ulamas, according to Sunnah, according to Quran. So there is no difference in the views of the ulama regarding this type of knowledge. A prominent Saudi scholar, Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen, said, astrology is a kind of sorcery and fortune telling. It is forbidden because it is based on illusion, not on concrete fact. So because it is such type of the knowledge depends on your imagination and not on the facts and figures. There is no relation between the movements of celestial bodies and what take place on the earth. So it means that stars and these heavenly bodies can't do anything to anyone. They are not responsible for any happening on the earth. Before the advent of Islam, people believed that the sun and moon eclipsed when the great figure died. It was the belief of the Arabs before Islam. During the lifetime of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it happened that the sun eclipsed when on the same day when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's son Ibrahim died. The people thought it had eclipsed because of the death of the Prophet's son. On hearing this, Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam led them in eclipse prayer, Salatul Kasuf, and then delivered a speech saying that when Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to know that people are saying such things, he just called them for salah, and then after salah he told them that inna ash-shamsa wal qamara ayatani min ayatillahi la yankasifani li mauti ahadin wala li hayatihi walakin Allah ta'ala yukhawwifu biha ibadahu. What's that meaning? The sun and the moon are but signs of Allah, they do not eclipse because of the death or the birth of anyone, but Allah the Almighty frightens His servants thereby. So these are only the signs of Allah Almighty. Allah shows that signs to the people to make them get afraid of Him, to know about the how great Allah Almighty is and what He can do. And we should then pray to Allah Almighty, and it's also meaning that we should believe in Allah Almighty, and all other things that we believe that they are powerful and they can do something, just like some people just worship sun and some people worship moon. So in this way their beliefs are actually denied. This indicates that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam denied any relationship between the movement of the heavenly bodies and events on the earth. And Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu reported, there is another hadith from Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is reported by Hazrat Ibn Abbas. He said that qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, من اقتبس علما من النجوم اقتبس شعبة من السحر زاد ما زاد. What's that meaning? He who acquires the knowledge of astrology, he acquires the knowledge of the branch of magic, and it increases and increases. So as the magic is haram in Islam, so same is getting the knowledge of stars believing that they are powerful and they can do each and everything. So half part of the lesson is enough for today. Tomorrow inshallah